about the MIPAWS is that we did collaborate, it happened 6 years ago. Bowman Dixon asked for advice for a new teacher that was joining his school. And there were a flurry of tweet responses, but people just couldn't get their ideas out in 140 characters. So people started writing these amazing blog posts that started being called Letters to a First-Year Teacher. They were all compiled and made into a PDF, which is on his blog, the link is there. But this compilation is one of my favorite things. I share it with all new math teachers, and it shows the power that we have when we work together. The link was up there. But also for many years, I've worked with others in this community to help people start their own blogs and learn about many of the things that the entire online math teacher community has to offer. So this is one of the examples. Today I wanted to share with you a project that I plan to happen in August. I hope it's as powerful as the Letters to a New Teacher like initiative, and it involves all of you, if you want to join in the fun. It's a virtual conference. What's it going to be about? The title is The Virtual Conference of Mathematical Flavors. Here's the thing. We are told to do about 1,000 things in our classroom. So here's a little bit of a rant. Build risk takers, have kids work collaboratively, provide rich tasks, utilize vertical non-permanent surfaces, high five kids every day, do random grouping, call on students with the popsicle sticks of destiny, instill grits in our kids, develop growth mindset, provide formative feedback, and alter our lessons based on it, do standard-based grading, engage kids with project-based learning. Obviously, we have to do lagging homework, or is the general trend no homework now? Be sure to interlink concepts so that you can make it stick, am I right? And make sure the kids have a facility with technology. But the thing is, we don't do all of that. And it would be crazy to do all of that. We as teachers pick and choose what makes sense to us based on where we are, who our kids are, and what we decide our goals are for our kids. And by doing that, we are actually shaping what kids think mathematics is really all about just in the year that they have with us. So here's what the conference is about. And after I explain, I'll tell you if you want to become a presenter how to do that. On the slides are two wordles from Tracy Zager's book, Becoming the Math Teacher You Wish You Had. The first are words that mathematicians use to describe mathematics. The second are words that teachers use to describe their own experiences as math students. These wordles were my inspiration for the name of this conference. I want you to take a moment and think about what your students would say about math, before they have their year with you. And then think about what your students would say what math is after their year with you. How would those two wordles be different? Your teaching practice has an impact on how your kids think about mathematics. Our classrooms are little bubbles, and while kids are sitting in them, they are picking up all kinds of signals about mathematics. All the micro things you do to shape your classroom, the atmosphere, the interactions, the curriculum, the doing of math, they all have a cumulative macro effect on what students think mathematics truly is. And that's what this conference is about. We all have our own unique flavor of mathematics, and we are imparting that to our students through how we orchestrate our classes day in and day out. So here's a formal prompt for the conference. How does your class move the needle on what your kids think about the doing of math, or what counts as math, or what math feels like, or even who can do math? Now here's how you can get involved. The conference, you will be happy to hear, has zero live speaking, except for this. You're welcome. It will be the online math teacher community all writing on this theme, where you share your classroom and how math is experienced by your students with all of us. You're just gonna blog your reflection. You have the rest of July and all of August to write this blog post, and then you're just gonna submit it to the Virtual Conference of Mathematical Flavors. Every Wednesday in August, all those who submitted their blog posts will be added to the Conference Convention Center, which is just a page on my blog. And at the end of the month, we're going to have an amazing archive of lots of different teachers, like flavors of math that kids experience in their classrooms. And you won't be the only ones participating. We have a great lineup of keynote speakers who will be writing about this prompt each week. And you can see it's an amazing lineup. But more than that, I would love it if we could hear your voice too, and a whole chorus of people from those here in this room attending TMC 18. I'm betting some of you are like, oh, cool, but this is like so anxiety-producing. I might not want to join it, but I just ask you to think about the vulnerable presentation that Casey gave and how she took a risk and it paid off. So I know it can be scary to put yourself out there, but just as we want kids to take risks, I'm gonna challenge you to take a risk too. And just think about it, what is this other than just writing a bit about your classroom, whether it's a paragraph or five paragraphs? So just think about it like that, something small. So for more information, you can just go to my blog, which is anthonyshaw.com. And thank you for considering joining me.